approaching... this is going to be a tough one. Let's see. I think maybe around this particular area will be a little bit better. Yep. Is that good? Now we can definitely see. It's a duiker. It's a baby duiker that this Marshall Eagle has got. Well, this is just quite a show of strength for this particular eagle to be able to bring down an eye duiker. Now, Em, you're wondering how they managed to bring down duikers. Well, this is quite a big eagle. It is the biggest eagle. And just checking here on the book, it says that they can reach about 85 centimeters in length. So very, very big. And about, if they're very big, about 5 kilograms. So that's quite a size bird. And the duiker that we're looking at, it seems to be still a very young duiker. Definitely not a fully grown one, just judging by the size of its head. But I'm so impressed. This is not a common sight. This is not something that we see often. And this is why we often say that in stormy weather, the antelope and prey species don't fare all that well. I mean, we've gone around and we've seen already two different birds of prey with their kills stashed up out of a tree. So there's little to, well, or there's actually a lot to believe that perhaps leopards are doing the exact same thing. Ooh, what was that? All right. Are you going to start feeding? This is quite an interesting sighting. It's always funny how all of these eagles surprise us with all different things. Oh yeah, I was so dumb, I didn't realize it dropped the kill. I was looking away in the distance. Well, it'll be very nice if it went all the way down and brought it back up. I think it's stressing now. Yeah, you dropped it. What are you going to do now? I think there was still a little bit of meat left, but probably considering its options, should I go down and try and get it and put it back up here? As you see, they're also very clever. They know where to put it to try and get it away from some of the other predators, particularly bigger predators, like a hyena, clearly, or perhaps even, I'm sure a serval would give a Marshall Eagle a bit of its run, or jackals, or leopards, and then, well, of course, if lions were to come across, I'm pretty sure they would try to get it from the eagle itself. Now, please do go down and get it. That'll be very interesting to watch. Definitely considering, and you see that it's upset. It keeps looking down, looking around. Is it worth it? Is it not worth it? Should I go down and get it, or should I just leave it? Very tough decision-making process. No? Are you not going down? Sorry guys, I am being called on the radio, so I'm just going to answer for a second. Standing by. I'm on Philemon Scotline Treehouse Dam Junction. Copy, thank you. Alright, are you gonna go down? Please do go down. Come on, look at those beautiful eyes. And it's such a powerful creature, and you can see standing all the talons, of very, very sharp talons. Whew. I think we're gonna give it a little bit of a... we're gonna wait. We're gonna give it a bit of a chance, see if perhaps it does go down and get the kill back up. Because it'll be quite interesting if it does, and obviously we want to see how this is going to play out and how this is going to end. But while we wait for this wonderful bird of prey to decide as to what it wants to do, we're going to send you guys across to the Mara with Jamie and some very fluffy little lion cubs.